Mythology and superstition have portrayed octopuses as evil creatures and giant monsters dwelling in the terrifying dark depths of oceans and capable of dragging an entire ship to the bottom. The legends about them embody everything creepy and mysterious about the sea. The thoughts of their soft, squishy bodies have inspired monsters ranging from the Kraken to the Caribbean Lusker. Their bizarre forms find their way into some modern monsters and villains too. Just remember Disney's sea witch Ursula or Spider-Man's Dr. Octopus. But in fact, octopuses are not as scary animals as they're depicted. They are some of the most fascinating and strange creatures on the planet. Let's find out more about these marine inhabitants. Octopuses live in oceans all over the world. On this map, their habitats are marked in yellow. Octopuses are invertebrates, which means they have no spine. Their bodies are soft and boneless, so they can rapidly alter their shape, which enables them to squeeze through small cracks, crevices, and escape through drain holes, possibly back into the ocean. There are around 300 species of octopuses. They fall into two suborders, namely Sirina and Inserina. Sirina or cirrate octopuses live exclusively far down in the dark ocean depths. They have two paddle-shaped fins on the sides of their heads, which help them swim through the water. These creatures often have a bizarre appearance. For example, the Dumbo octopus is so named because of the two fins above its eyes that look like the big ears of Walt Disney's flying elephant. Another group, the Inserina, includes many of the better-known and more normal-looking octopus species, most of which are bottom-dwellers. A narghinaut is a unique type of octopus of this suborder. Unlike other today's octopuses, female argonauts secrete a thin calcite shell in which they lay their eggs. The blanket octopus is perhaps one of the most unusual sea creatures. It looks like a wet blanket floating in the ocean. The blanket is a web of skin that connects the long arms of the female blanket octopus. The blue-ringed octopus may be a beautiful creature, but it is recognized as one of the world's most deadly animals. Its poison is strong enough to kill a human, and to make matters worse, there is no known antidote. Octopuses come in many different sizes. The world's smallest known species is the octopus wolfie. This little guy is the size of a pencil eraser. And the giant Pacific octopus is considered the largest octopus species in the world. Its arm span can be about the height of a two-story building. The body of an octopus is oval in shape, soft, and dressed in a mantle. The mantle is basically a muscular sac. It can be smooth, pimpled, or wrinkled. An octopus's mantle contains organs such as a brain, digestive system, three hearts, and other organs. They are all crammed into this one space. The octopus's mouth is on its underside. It has a veritable Swiss Army knife of tools located inside its mouth to pry open shells it can't open with its arms. Directly inside its mouth, it has a hard retractable beak similar to a parrot's. This beak is useful for breaking open clamshells and tearing apart flesh. Next to the beak is the radula, a barbed tongue the octopus uses to scrape the prey out of its shell once the shell is opened. And if these tools don't do the trick, it also has an organ called the salivary papilla that can be used to drill into shells. Relative to their body size, octopuses generally have large eyes. The morphology of the human eye and the octopus eye is very similar. However, to focus its eyes, an octopus does not change the shape of its lens, as is the case in humans. Instead, it moves its rigid lens back and forth, as in a camera. By copying the structure of an octopus eye, camera manufacturers were able to create a camera lens that can now produce a clear picture. The octopus belongs to the class Cephalopoda, which means that these animals' arms branch directly off their heads. Octopuses' eight appendages are actually arms, not tentacles, as they are often mistakenly called. Each of an octopus's arms is lined with two rows of suction cups that allow the animal to grab prey and different objects. Each cup is packed with chemical receptors that perceive smell and taste on contact. For example, they can discern crabs from rocks despite their similar size, shape, and hardness. By the way, octopuses are carnivorous, and so often feed on crabs, shrimp, clams, and fish. Octopus arms are incredibly strong and flexible. Without bones and joints to limit movements, they have an almost infinite range of motion. Made almost entirely of muscle, the arms are strong enough to wrestle sharks and to break through plexiglass. Robotics engineers are interested in the arms too. They believe that an octopus arm provides a good template for how to create a strong but flexible robotic arm. Such an arm would be extremely useful in delicate surgeries or in unpredictable search and rescue situations. As opposed to a centralized nervous system like that of vertebrates, 2/3 of an octopus's neurons is spread throughout its body. The nervous system is controlled by the central brain. In addition, there is a small brain in each of their 8 arms. Each arm has its own ganglia, or cluster of neurons, so it is capable of acting independently. It can make basic decisions for itself and do certain tasks at once. Another interesting fact about octopuses is their blood. Human blood is red because hemoglobin is iron-rich and red in color. But in octopuses, there isn't iron but copper. And instead of hemoglobin in the blood, there is hemocyanin. This is why octopus blood is blue rather than red. This copper base is more efficient at transporting oxygen in cold, hypoxic conditions. Most octopuses are generally reddish-brown in color, but they can change color at will, depending on their mood. When an octopus is scared, it turns white. When angry, it turns red. What does it mean when an octopus turns yellow? It turns yellow in its sleep, so it's very easy to understand when an octopus is taking a nap. An octopus uses a variety of methods to defend itself against predators. It can bend its body to squeeze through and hide under rocks. It can also change to gray, brown, pink, blue or green to blend in with the surroundings. Specialized cells in their skin, called chromatophores, expand and contract to produce an array of colors, patterns, and textures. They also alter the position of the muscles to change the skin's texture to masquerade as seaweed or rocks. Perhaps the most impressive of all these impersonators is the mimic octopus. By contorting its body and arranging its arms, it can turn into a wide variety of venomous animals. If chased, an octopus resorts to its second line of defense by releasing a squirt of black ink. To top it off, the ink contains a compound that impairs smell and taste, which further confuses the predator. If all else fails, as a last resort, an octopus can lose an arm to escape a predator's grasp and then regrow it later with no permanent damage to the body, just like a lizard sheds its tail. Octopuses are among the most intelligent of all invertebrates. Stories abound of some individuals that manage to escape from their aquariums and climb into others to get to the food. A female octopus in a German zoo has learned to unscrew the lid from a jar of shrimps. Captive octopuses are also able to distinguish various geometric shapes and tackle simple mazes. Well, that's all we wanted to tell you about octopuses. These 8-armed geniuses are playful, inquisitive, sensitive, determined, and worthy of our protection. And they still harbor many secrets from us. See you next time!